Greetings from the Hydra-Test team. This is a video guide to explain basic principles of operation of our flagship valve body testing unit, HT-VBT Deluxe. First of all, before performing a test, you mount a valve body to an adapter plate, which is then connected to the testing unit with a harness set. Connection charts show which number hoses should be fitted to the relevant connection fittings. They would also give users a detailed picture of the valve body itself with solenoids named for ease of use when testing. This is the starting process whenever we begin testing. In Select Transmission, you will find all gearboxes placed in the data folder. Typically, you would have Auto, Single, Step test modes. At this stage, we select our mode of testing. These modes refer to different pressure settings. In Auto mode, it simulates various throttle positions, so you will start at low pressure and then steadily increase the pressure until you get all the way up to the maximum pressure input value. In the Auto version, the machine is set to do that for you, so you don't have to increase the pressure by turning the potentiometer manually. By simply pressing the Manual to Auto button above the potentiometer, the machine will take control of setting the pressure and therefore eliminate operator error when selecting your input pressures. In single mode, you will be asked to perform the test at one particular pressure of 15 to 30 bar, whatever is suitable for that particular valve body. In the step version, it will do exactly the same thing, but pressure input value has to be altered manually. The operator will have to turn the potentiometer manually in order to change pressures. Let us start with an exercise where we select single mode, then we can choose the master data. Master data is the performance data captured from a new, well-performing valve body of a particular model tested through the complete test scenario cycle. These scenarios are written by our team exclusively for certain models through HT Control Editor, which is now available for the user's convenience too. Comparison of newly captured data against the master data reveals how well or how poor this valve body performs compared to the benchmark. Our data helps you to get started with testing, but the great feature is that you can save your own master data for reference and comparison, so we greatly encourage you to do so after you have successfully finished a rebuilding procedure or have a new valve body and know that the valve body performs correctly. You should also note at which ATF temperature you have recorded the data, because it does make a difference to the graph. At low temperature, the pressure will be higher. And at high temperature, the pressure will be lower. Don't miss this point. PDF allows you to open the connection chart. Test solenoids is the first operation in select mode. It allows users to check the current of a solenoid, making sure that it works electrically. It will have the master data values to compare against, and users will also see the actual current values. It is important to run this test with due regard for the temperature. Note that our controller system, HTC-K, has advanced and our current checks are quite accurate, so you can override the master data and you are welcome to do it. Test solenoids mode is also quite useful to check how well you attach the cable to solenoids. If you are reading 0 amps, it will mean that there is a misconnection. Test scenario is the next option in select mode. In this window, we capture the data, we record and save tests. At the end of the test, there will be a chart for comparison against the master data chart, and there will also be separate tables to see the differences related to the values of pressure and PWM, or pulse width modulation. Manual mode is the third option in select mode. We will run through this mode now. After you press continue, you can use the up and down arrows to select gears. In first gear, the K1 clutch is supposed to be on. You can see digit 1 there. Green marks are the master data tolerances. You want the readings to be within the green field as far as possible. We have set the tolerance for master data as 20%. If we had it set for an exact figure, we would always be outside the master data guidelines due to ATF temperature differences and differences within the valve bodies. If you go into the HT control editor, you can change the tolerance for currents and pressures and set them as high or low as you choose. You will have to manually set system pressure with the black potentiometer on the right-hand side of your machine to 20 bar. This pressure can generally vary from 15 to 30 bar depending on the test. So if you choose single mode, you have to switch pressure values manually. Auto mode is the fourth option in select mode. During this test, you don't have to select your gears manually by pressing the up or down arrows. The machine will shift automatically in loop form until you press stop. So it's a good mode to use if you want to get the machine warmed up to temperature, since in most cases you wish to have hot ATF for your tests. There is a heater button on the front of the machine that you can press while the test is running. You can get it to high temperature to have accurate results. Auto mode 2 is the final, fifth option in select mode. This mode is mainly used for clutch checks. You can see K1 test being performed, and it will do so with B1 test, K3 test, and so on. The reason for those checks with different valve bodies that we run is to check pressure control solenoids. This works very well with some ASIN Warner models, for instance, when the rebuilders want to calibrate their solenoids in live view. You can press live view, and you will see the outgoing pressure for particular clutches individually. Some of the solenoids can be calibrated during the test procedure, that is, with implementation of some tools. System pressure will demonstrate the pressure that you have set by turning the potentiometer on the machine and how the incoming pressure varies. It can also show you current on particular solenoids. Note that live view will only be operable in the auto mode. In the manual mode, this feature won't be highlighted, but in the manual mode, you can control the solenoids. As for the duty cycle, PWM solenoids typically run on 60%, while shift solenoids, DC or direct current solenoids, typically run on 100%. 0.31, for instance, stands for 0.31 amps. Solenoids are lit up in green when activated, and we can read the current values from them. The important thing here is with the test scenario mode. This is where we record information. After you press start, the pop-up window will guide you through on-screen instructions, asking you to set the relevant pressures and to select drive by moving the lever that controls the manual valve before pressing continue. At the end of the test, you will be asked to select reverse by once again moving the position of the manual valve with your lever. When the test scenario is finished, you will have a graph of the test that you have just completed, and you can use it for comparison against the master data. You can use various options. Save this test, name it as you please, and record the temperature of your completed test. Optionally, you may also override the existing master data with your new data. We would like to emphasize how easy it is to save the information that you have recorded. Thus, you create your own library to come back to and to compare against. The pre-installed information that we supply our customers with is the guideline, but the information that the customers save in-house is supposed to be even more valuable for them in the future. This is due to the fact that valve body rebuilding workshops are going to process more valve bodies and capture more info compared to us as equipment manufacturers. We have every type of valve body, but just one of each type, while the end users deal with multiples of each type. It's crucial that the user saves information properly. In the bottom left corner, you can turn solenoids on and off if needed. Off is to switch them off. DEF is for default, which actually means on. When the scenario is finished, you have a new window that shows the graph with newly acquired info that comes as a solid line, and the master data graph comes as a dotted line. It is easy to go through the whole test, switch showing certain information on and off. In our case, the graphs coincide precisely, since it is the same valve body being run. In most cases, the result graph will be slightly higher or lower. You will have our guidelines and stipulations. By right-clicking, you can check the current or pressure at a particular moment of time, bar, amps, seconds. Axis sync options will allow you to work your way with scaling for a better view. For example, if we wish to see K1 clutch only, we can see the following. At the beginning stages of the test, the K1 clutch operates in first and will stay on until you reach fifth gear. After that, it will go on again at fourth. So the graph will show you what a particular clutch is doing at a particular moment of time. When we exit the graphs that appear after the test scenario has been run, the system will ask if you wish to save the data. You can do it and name the data however you need for your convenience. In order to access the information, you may go into HT Control Viewer to compare various result graphs with one another. You can choose up to two master graphs in this case. M1 is dotted lines, M2 is dashed dot lines. In effect, you can compare your result with more than two master graphs, but simply not at the same time. In HT Control Editor, you can create your own scenarios. This is for expert users who wish to elaborate their own scripts, scenarios for particular, unique valve bodies. In HT Control Editor, you can open any PRFL files to see the scenario in detail. Solenoid implemented, gears, duration in milliseconds, etc. Analog outputs. This is where we set voltage in the auto version so we can control the pressure that is read out. In this case, we can use channel 2 for this purpose. Channel 1 is assigned for the switch valve, which is either on or off, so we use channel 2, analog output 2, for varying pressure values. So, thus we control the proportional valve. Channels 3 and 4 are options for the transmission dyno. In the editor, you can see that for scenarios that come in the auto mode of testing, we set certain voltage at particular steps. That is used for the automatic control of pressure when the users don't change it manually. You can see some fields highlighted in red and some in yellow. The red color is for auto mode 1 and the yellow is for auto mode 2. When you select manual mode, you will be clicking through all steps manually, with every click getting closer to the end of the test. In the test scenario, it will go all the way through without the user's interference. Pass-through means that you won't have to click through that step in the manual mode of testing. It will go straight from first gear to second. 160 is the percentage for duty cycles. 100 is for shift solenoids, DC solenoids, and 60 is for PWM, pulse width modulation solenoids. Concerning interpolation parameters, you see that N88 is the DC solenoid with 100%, N90, N282 are PWM solenoids with 60%. In interpolation parameters, solenoids 3 and 4 are PWMs, and we want to gradually ramp them on and ramp them off. We are controlling these solenoids being broad on and off. With the DC solenoids, they just go on and off, so we don't need to use interpolation with them, while the PWMs, we want them to go smooth. This is the point. Ramping on and off means that the PWM solenoids will go to the 60% of the duty cycle with 1% steps rather than doing this abruptly. You're welcome to visit our website, www.hydratest.co.uk, and contact us for more details or make an inquiry.